Southwest kids, and welcome to The Zone. I'm Miss Sue, and I'm so glad you're here. It's a brand new month. May is here, and I have some goals. That's right. I am gonna run a 5K. That's almost 3 miles. But to do that, I gotta put some training in. So I'm hoping that you guys can help me, because I've gotta work out, I gotta eat right, I gotta get enough sleep, and I gotta do all the things it takes to run a race. I wanna finish well. So if you could help me, that would be awesome. Now today though, we have some amazing stories about people who are committed. And that is our life app this month. It's commitment. Commitment is making a plan and putting it into practice. Making a plan and putting it into practice. That is right. And we have a new verse too, and it helps so much as I'm planning for my 5K, as I'm planning for my life, because you gotta do that in your life too. You gotta train your body. Training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises health for the life you are now living and the life to come. That's 1 Timothy 4:8. Training the body has some value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises health from the life you are now living and the life to come. 1 Timothy 4:8. Learn that this month. It'll help you with your goals and your life. And guess what? We have something else to come along and help us to train. It's time for a game. I'm gonna go run. See you later.
Where's Hunter?
Where is he?
One. Two.
What are you doing?
I'm training.
For what?
For the big game, okay? We're training for the big game. We want to get pumped up today, okay?
That hurt my ear.
Okay, today, I'm not just Game Master Hunter. Today, I am Trainer Hunter. You understand? Okay? You see? You see? Okay. Okay. Okay, kids. Okay. Listen, weightlifting might not be my forte, okay? But I'm all about cardio, okay? I'm all about the running. As you can see from my slender physique. Am I right? Okay. Listen, it's not that heavy, okay? It was for show, all right? But anyway, guys, what we've got here, okay? You wanna go ahead and introduce yourselves to our friends? This is Jaden for the boy team, for the guys, come on! Woo! And over here, we have Callan for the girls team. Come on, be excited! We're training today, okay? You guys might be wondering why I'm a little amped up. For the most part, it's because I got coffee this morning. But it's because I love to run and I love to win prizes, okay? So today's game, everybody, what we're gonna do, we got a bucket of clothes here, as you guys can see, okay? These two are gonna go for a run. Okay, I didn't tell them that, but I'm gonna go make them run after this.
Wait, what?
Yeah, you like that.
I don't want to run. I don't like running, unless I'm playing
The first key to overcoming anything is doing things you don't want to do. No, I'm kidding. So what we're gonna have you guys do today, okay? You guys are going to steal stuff out of this, but not steal.
I thought stealing was illegal.
It is, but for the same, the name of the game, you do what you gotta do to win. So basically, kids, what we're gonna do, we got a bucket of clothes, a bucket of running supplies. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna have these kids dress up to go for their run. And we're gonna see who dresses up the best to be the best runner. Okay?
Okay.
You guys know any famous runners?
No.
Me neither, because no one likes to run.
I guess my dad. Okay.
My brother likes to run.
Okay, but we're gonna add a little wrench in the gears, kids. Not only are they going to be getting dressed up to go for their run.
Shoot.
Yeah. You're gonna be doing it blindfolded. Wit. Boom.
There we go.
That's what I meant. Colors are important, guys. Okay. Need help tying that?
No.
I know your mom helps you tie your shoes. No? I'm just kidding. And you don't even tie your shoes. So, kids, start doing some warm-ups, okay?
Wait.
Because you guys are gonna go for a run with us after this.
I can't see anything.
Yeah. Tire you out for mom and dad. You love that? Okay. Let's see, you guys all blind?
I can't see any of this.
Okay, good.
Okay, you're good to go. You're good to go. Awesome. Let's have you two stand up. Boom. Let's have you stand up. Come here a little bit. Okay, the bucket is right in front of both of you. Okay? So, there you go. Now, hold on. Back up. There we go. Okay. Timer. Huh? Race master. Oh, we got the timer going. This is exciting. Are you ready?
Maybe.
You guys understand what you're doing?
Yes. Probably.
Do you at home understand what they're doing? Great.
Maybe.
Three, two.
Please don't fall on my head.
One, go!
No, me. You're me.
Wait, we have to put them on?
I just want to get a quick laugh. Yeah, go ahead, try. Yep, there you go. Okay.
What is this?
Come on.
Is this a sweatshirt? Okay.
Be better! Yeah! There we go. Okay, you look like you're going for a sprint.
Get some. Okay. I live in Canada.
Wait, that's too many goggles.
I can't. Wait. I can't see anything. Oh, this is a backpack. I need to put my water in my backpack.
Okay.
Sock.
Huh, you guys having some trouble there?
I got a backpack.
Well, it looks like
on.
One of you isn't having trouble.
I have a backpack.
Okay. Backpack, he's ready to go. Might go for a hike, all terrain.
No, it's to hold your water.
Hey, why are you talking? Keep getting dressed, buddy. Come on.
That feels like a weird thing to say to him.
10 seconds.
What, 10 seconds.
Seconds.
Oh, no. Oh, man. Seven, ah! Six, five, four, three, two, one. Ding dong. Okay, guys, coach is a little out of breath.
Hi.
Okay, let's see. Let's see here, everybody at home. Can I go ahead and have you stand up?
Do we take off our blindfolds?
I kind of like how they look on for a second. Let's see. Let's see.
Well, hello there.
Okay, I think I have a winner. Does Mr. have a winner? I think we have a winner. Okay, you guys want to go ahead and take your blindfolds off, perhaps?
Sure.
Here, wait. I have goggles. Okay, there we go.
Okay, so let's look at these two runners, guys.
My backpack.
You look like you ran through your older sister's closet. You look like you're gonna go run on the beach, which is what I would rather do, you understand?
Oh, yes.
So do you know what that means? The girls won this one, boys! Thought you were gonna win, huh?
I have to.
That's right.
That's a bit ridiculous.
Give me some, give me some.
Oh,
I'm glad you guys got to exercise with us, get the heart rate going, okay? I need you all to get up on your feet. Out of your seat and get ready for some worship. Are you ready for some worship?
Backspace.
I'm ready to worship you, God.
Waking up, knowing there's a reason. All my dreams come alive. Life is for living with you. I've made my decision. You lift me up, fill my eyes with wonder. For every young in your love, this freedom's untainted. With you, no moment is wasted. We'll be right back.
What can I do to leave a legacy? How can I speak with authority when I can't see you? I can't see you. How can I know the dreams you have for me? How do I believe beyond what I have seen when I can't hear you? I can't feel you now. No, 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 no. You're my revival song. You start where I belong. On my knees, on my knees. When I'm weak, you're strong. You meet me here when I'm on my knees, on my knees. Oh, it starts with me. I try to work outside of you, knocking down doors I shouldn't be going through. But I'm so tired, I'm so tired. You take my burdens off of my shoulders. You break the lies that hold me back. So I know that you're enough.
Worship time was quite a workout. I'm out of breath. Woo, good training. Now Nolan is going to tell us all about what training we need if we want to have a full life in Jesus. So get your Bibles out because it's time to look into God's big story. Take it away, Nolan.
Hey, Southwest kids, how you doing today? I hope you've all had just a really peaceful day. I say that because last month we studied peace all through the month. I hope it made a difference in your life. It certainly made a difference in mine, seeing how I can work together with people instead of arguing with them. That's kind of a good way to be. And to be prepared for things like that, this month we're going to talk about commitment. Commitment. It sounds like a really big word, but it just means putting a plan into practice and following that plan, you know, maybe to achieve a goal. I want to share something with y'all right now, and it's going to sound like I'm bragging. I'm not. I got nothing to brag about, but I had a mom and daddy that really encouraged me in everything in which I had interest. And so I want to take y'all through some examples of things that I committed to in my life, and then we'll segue into the Bible, see what God has to say about things and about how we can apply commitment into our lives living for Jesus. So my point is this. A lot of you probably are, you know, you play musical instruments, you sing, you play soccer, baseball, maybe you're great at writing, whatever it is, but maybe it's video games. But you worked at it. You probably weren't good just right off the bat. You had to practice. You had to practice. You had to practice. And the more you practice, more than likely the better you got. Now, some of you may be like me. I just wanted to be better. The neighborhood I grew up in, I was the youngest kid in the neighborhood. All the other guys were like 3 or 4 years older than me. They're all riding their bicycles. I got training wheels. I didn't want to be out there on training wheels. I want to be able to ride a bike. But every time I tried without training wheels, I'd fall and I would just give up. Well, my mother and father came alongside and said, look, if you want to get out there and ride with the big kids, you've got to practice this every day until you figure it out. So instead of whining and complaining about it, I finally did that. And I did figure it out. It was the same way playing with those guys playing football. You know, I'm smaller than them. You know, what have you. I can't throw. I can't catch as well as they can't run any faster. But, and I would just whine about it. My parents would say, hey, practice throwing and catching, and then you will get better. It's okay that you're younger. And sure enough, every day when daddy would get home from work or mom would get home from work, they'd throw the ball to me out in the yard, you know, whatever, throw it until I got, so I got better at it. And I enjoyed that. I worked hard at it. One of my favorite stories, you probably think it's funny, I played basketball in junior high and high school. I wasn't a very good player, and I was extremely right-handed. And so anytime I had to go use my left hand, I'd get the ball stolen from me. One of my coaches, and again, I'm lamenting that fact all the time, complaining about it. One of my coaches says, Nolan, you've got to practice with your left hand. He goes, I see you start and you don't. Here, I got a way that can help you. He tied my right hand behind my back. And every day at practice for 15 minutes, I had to dribble with just my left hand until I got where I could use my left hand. Well, see, that was a plan. I put it into practice and I sort of committed to it. About that same time, I played tennis growing up. Still do, still enjoy it. I could hit a forehand, I could hit a volley, I could serve. My backhand wasn't very good. It wasn't very good. And this young lady, of which I was sweet on, she was a very good player. She was a top-ranked player in the state. And I would be at the park hitting tennis with her, and anytime she hit it to my backhand, I'd miss it. Well, it drove me crazy. So I started getting on my bicycle, riding to the park, getting out there, and hitting nothing but backhands against a concrete block wall. Just hit, hit, hit. Hit. I did it over and over and over again. I was really committed to getting better at this, and sure enough, finally I got it. And I'm here to tell you today, only Roger Federer and Miss Sue have a better backhand than I have this day. Now, I tell you all of this not because I'm bragging, but to tell you about what I committed to get better at what I thought was important. Well, I'm here to tell you there's a whole lot of things a whole lot more important than, you know, singing better or running faster or hitting a tennis ball. None of those things are bad, but I was missing out on what is truly important. Where can we go find out what is truly important in life? Y'all are right. Y'all get me every time. It's the Bible. We get in the Word of God. God's servant Matthew wrote these words many, many years ago. It was actually the words that Jesus said. Jesus was teaching a group of people and explaining things to them, and he got asked a question. He told him, he goes, the most important commandment is this, you know, love the Lord with all your heart, with all your soul, with all your mind, and the second most important is like it, love others more than yourself. Jesus said that was the most important thing. It wasn't whether I could hit a tennis ball or catch a football or ride a bike. So I think about it when I was growing up, I was always, and again, none of those things were bad, but I spent all my time on that. And maybe I didn't spend it in the Bible or spend it in prayer or spend it in talking to others about Jesus or just going out there and living for Jesus. So that's what I want to talk to y'all a little bit more about today. Hey, again, we talked earlier, the video games. Y'all probably, there's a sequence you got to go through. There's buttons you got to press. But I bet you practice it. You ask people about it. Maybe you read about it. Maybe you get someone older to show you. Maybe you get someone to talk to you about it. What if you did the same thing with how you're living for Jesus? What if you did the same thing to do what we were just read and heard about was the most important thing that you can do? Let me give you another example. I've run 11 marathons in my life. A marathon is 26.2 miles long. Don't know why I got into it. My father used to run. My grandfather used to run. My great-grandfather used to run. So it's just in me. Now, I didn't win anything. I wasn't fast. But to run a marathon, you've got to train. You've got to have a plan in place, and you've got to practice all the time. In fact, before I ran my first marathon, I found me a plan. It's 4 months long. And I ran over 500 miles in those 4 months before I ran that marathon. Sometimes there were long runs, sometimes there were short runs. But I got this plan, I stuck to it, I did it every day, and it got me in shape where I could run that marathon. And again, wow, that's great, and I love it, and I've enjoyed running marathons, I've met people, I've traveled, I mean, that's been great. But none of that is as important as the, you know, marathon's a race, I forgot to tell you that. None of that is important as the race we're in right now with God and to make His Son famous. We're in that race right now. So there's four things we're going to be talking about each week this month that are very important on your practice plan or your training plan and to show your commitment to Jesus. The first thing you can do is you can hear from God. You can hear from God. How do you hear from God? The Bible. You study the Bible. You ask questions about the Bible. You come to Tuesday Night Kids. You come to the Zone on Sunday, and you listen. You hear the Word of God and how you can use that and in your life. The second thing we talk about all the time is prayer. God loves to spend time with you in prayer, whether you're talking to Him or you're listening to Him. Prayer is such an important part of your life. I hope you have family time prayer with your family, or you find time just to spend time with God. That's another thing to which we can commit to getting better about serving Jesus. The other thing is to talk about Jesus, just like we're doing right now. You can talk with your friends. You can talk with your mom and daddy. You can talk with all us leaders at the Zone. We'd love to visit with you. That's why we break into small groups and talk about Jesus, because that's how we honor this commitment to Him. That's how we try to get better at everything we do for Him. And then finally, you live for Jesus, not just when you're in the Zone, just not at Tuesday Night Kids, not just when you're at church, but in your neighborhood, in your school, out and about around strangers. You live the way Jesus would want you to live. Right? Let me share our memory verse with you for this month. It comes from 1 Timothy chapter 4, verse 8. It says, training your body has value, but being godly has value in every way. It promises to help you in this life now and that one to come. Right? So when I was younger, all these things I want to get better at, and again, they weren't bad, I really committed to them, but they were not nearly as important as if I'd made a commitment to the Bible and to learning more about Jesus. God's servant Paul writes to us in 1 Corinthians chapter 9, verse 24 and 25. I want to read them to you right now. Do you not know that those who run in a race all run, but only one receives the prize? Run in such a way that you will win. Everyone who competes in the games exercises self-control in all things. They then do it to receive a perishable wreath, but we an imperishable one. Let me tell you what that means right quick. Back in the day, races, that was the entertainment. That's what they did back in Greece. They had these kind of like Olympic games, okay? And the prize was a wreath made up of flowers or pine or something like that. Well, in a few days, that thing rotted and perished. What Paul was telling the people in Corinth at that time in this passage, he goes, hey, that's great that you take care of your body, but if you run this race with Jesus, if you run to live with Him, if you run to make Him famous, you're going to get a wreath, a trophy, a prize that no one can ever take away from you and last forever, and that's eternity with God in His wonderful heaven that He's made for us. So thank y'all for joining me today. Let me pray us out right quick. Father God, oh, we want to run the race with you. We thank you for tennis and bicycling and singing and dancing and being an actor. What all these things we get to do here on planet Earth. We thank you for those, and we pray that we would work hard to do our best in those. But Father God, like you shared with us today, it's so much more important to work on the things that'll help us serve you better. So Father God, we pray that we would hear from your word, that we would pray with you like we're doing right now, that we would talk to others about Jesus, and we would live for you wherever we are in this life. Thank you for your son, Jesus. It's in his name we pray. Amen, amen, amen.
Wow, it looks like we have a lot to do to practice to become great followers of Jesus. And I just appreciate that God has written it down for us. Love 1 Corinthians 9:25. And remember, God will be with us, each of us, every day. as we walk through this. We're not alone. So the bottom line, the thing I want to you to remember most is keep practicing what matters. To have a great relationship with God, we need to remember and keep practicing these things. The question for today is, how does practice help you? So talk with your family, talk with your friends, and figure out the answer to that question. I had a great time today. This was amazing. We are on a journey to train to be great, great followers of Jesus. So I will see you next week. And don't forget to go out and know God, love Him, and serve Him. Bye for now. I'll see you next week.